Violence and outrage in Atlanta after police shot and killed a black man over the weekend. Joining us now to weigh in is Trump 2020 Advisory Board member Steve Rogers, a former FBI Joint Terrorism Task Force member and New Jersey police officer as well. So we wanted you to educate us a little bit, if you would, sir. As we've seen the video, this stop apparently started a guy is kind of, as I understand. Now, we're looking at the shooting right here. I don't know if you can see it. But he looks to be running away and turns around and points a taser. It looks like he shoots it toward the officer and then gets shot. But I want to back up before that moment and say, could the officer have just let him go at the beginning, saying, you're drunk, call a cab, in that situation? And then when the officer said, we're going to arrest you, then the gentleman kind of got angry. So what were your thoughts when you were looking at the beginning of that video?
Well, the police were very calm. They were very professional. They did everything by the book. And you cannot let a drunk driver go. You cannot put him in a cab and expect them to go home. If that drunk driver is let go, and by the way, that's something we used to do years ago. But because of drunk drivers not going home and end up killing people by getting into another car, there were major lawsuits, so now there's mandatory arrests. Yeah. And that's to protect the people, you know, as well as the driver. So they were calm. They did their job. It was at the time that they placed him under arrest that he, not the police, that he escalated it to where it ended up.
Steve, after looking at the video, is there something different you think the police officers could have done?
Not at all. I've got to tell you, what people need to understand is that when you are fighting the police, and then you grab a weapon, that taser became a weapon, and you're running from the police, and then turn, and then fire. That in that police officer's mind, his life could have been in danger. Had he gotten hit, who knows if that guy would have went for his gun or not. But what should have been done differently is the driver should have complied. And all these incidents we're seeing is the result of people not complying. Had he complied, he'd be alive. Now, it was a tragic death. No one wants to see anyone die. But we must put things in perspective. What do we expect the police to do when they're under attack? These cops were under attack.
Yeah. And by the way, the questions we're asking, so you can educate us, I don't want to take a position on this, as you say, a terrible situation that this gentleman ended up dead. Like years ago, they used to have, they would follow these runaway, like in Los Angeles, these runaway cars, and then they'd chase them and somebody end up getting hurt. They stopped doing that and then would arrest them later. Is there a scenario in which they could have let this guy go? Yeah, he had the taser. He got into a fight. I don't know if mentally you can let this happen as a police officer, but could they have let him go? They know what his car is. They know who he is. They could go arrest him later.
Well, think about this. If they let him go and he drives and your relative's driving down the street and he runs into him because he's drunk and kills them, how would you think the cops would feel?
Sure.
And these are good, legitimate questions because people are asking them. With regard to what you said in reference to high-speed chases, yes, I agree. Only in cases where it's a motor vehicle violation. You got a bank robber, armed robbers, that's a whole other story. But in a case like this, nothing else could have been done. The police were very professional. And in my view, there'll be a trial, and that police officer will be exonerated because in his mind, I'm sure he believed his life was in danger.
Very quick question. You got about 10 seconds. When a police officer shoots at someone, they are trained to shoot at the core, right? They don't shoot at legs or anything like that.
You're absolutely right. They're not shoot to kill. They're shoot to eliminate the threat. But you shoot at the mast. Why? You don't want to hit anyone else that may be in the line of fire.
Okay. Thank you so much for educating us. I think it's questions a lot of people have. And like you said, this gentleman unfortunately escalated this, and it ended up very a horrible result. Thank you so much, sir.
You're welcome.
And we'll have more in the